I'd like to talk to you about the maquette and the important role it played in the preparation, development, and fabrication of Mathemalchemy project. I'm used to work with maquette. I've been working with them for many years, developing my own 3D project and mural, and I find it a very important tool to develop. I start with the drawing, and then I make a low-budget paper maquette, and I can evaluate the potential of the piece, its visual angles, correct error that are showing in the maquette, and after that, I'm ready to decide if it's going to be a good project to work seriously on. Normally, for my pieces, a maquette, that process takes about a few weeks, but with 23 people in Mathemalchemy, the maquette process took months. And I will try to explain you why it took so long, but how important it was. There's been three different final maquette in this project. The first one, the role of the first one, Ingrid and I, we developed that in the fall of 2019. And the concrete goal of that was to bring it to the GMM in Denver, January 2020. And it was helping us to explain the project, our vision, and to invite people, artists and mathematicians, to join us, because from the beginning, it was meant to be a collaborative work. It worked. 14 people joined us during that in Denver. And then over the month that followed, we were able to have more people joining us to have the final number of 23 participants. We were supposed to meet in Durham, but in March, it became obvious with the pandemic that we would stay home. Instead of saying we put that project aside, we pushed forward, organized Zoom meeting, and spent 3 days working on the idea and developing. At the end of the 3 days, it was decided that the first ID, the first vision, was too simple, that we wanted to make something more complex, more advanced, more developed. So it was the end of the role of the first maquette. So we began a long process of exploring, discussing, planning, sketching ideas about what we wanted to do in that installation. And it became clear for me within a few months that we needed a simple maquette to explain proportion. So in a week, I rush and prepare a very ugly little thing with green cardboard, but it showed the proportion. So I took picture and presented them to the next meeting, and it became clear for the whole group that the Riemann Hill was too small. The bay, if we want to have a complex boat, talking about nautical and many other elements, the ocean was too small, the bay was too narrow. And another thing that I wanted to push, is that the very good idea of a lighthouse, it looked too realistic. And I want them to create a lighthouse that would be more poetic, more artistic, and showing them a realistic lighthouse was a starting point to open the discussion about that. Following that, it was time to begin the process of creating the final maquette. The two first ones, they were made 1/8 of the scale of the real piece. And with all the detail, the complexity of the work, and the role of the maquette to show people every element they had invent or compose or create, I needed something a bit bigger. So it was approved that the next maquette would be quarter of a size of the real piece. So we doubled the surface. And I began to use good material. So wood was brought to the piece, fabric. It was not only paper and cardboard anymore. To add the value and color and texture to the piece. Some of the elements were discussed, debated, fought. And I went back to my workshop all the time, create an element, took picture, and had to show it to be approved or put aside. And for some pieces, I had to work with up to 5 elements to make sure that it was the right one. But it was worth it. It may seem a very long process, but we had the time. But if we make big error on the full scale of the installation, this is costly. But on a maquette, it can be put aside and we start over and we correct the element we want to correct. Now that the final maquette is completed, has been approved by the whole group, and everybody became attached emotively to that piece, we are in the process of fabrication. And the maquette is still there to help because it's guiding us for material, it's guiding us for color and tone, and it helped me a lot to plan the sequence of fabrication. And even if we live in an unrealistic period, we need realistic deadlines. And the maquette helped us plan realistic deadlines. So that the maquette has played its role and is still working for everybody, I concentrate my energy on the textile element of the piece. I'm in charge of the large page, the cryptography quilt, and the cavalcade of sheets. So, but that I will talk to you another time.